Well, it's time now for our children's story. Ferolyn is going to be giving our children's story. So as the young people come forward and they're picking up their love offering, please remember that these funds go to support the Sabbath Square and the activities that they do.
And then I will declare to them, never knew you. Depart from me, you practice lawlessness? What motivated these people? And how do we know that? These people were handing out tracts. These people were possibly giving Bible studies. They were going to feed the homeless. They were doing all the same things that the other group did. So what makes the difference?
They did it for a reward.
That's right. These people were keeping a list. And they had that list ready when Jesus came. And they said, look at all these things that we've done. They're good things. You need to take us to heaven because we've earned it. And what is the saddest words that we get ever hear? That Jesus was... their result. Everlasting separation from Jesus. Yes. So now that we've looked at these examples in the scriptures, does that mean that we can go about and look at other people and say, oh, their motive is selfish, their motive is not? Can we do that? No, only Jesus can read the heart. So the next time that God puts an opportunity in your path for you to help somebody, and you're motivated to help them, look and see what your motivation is. Now I want to close with one more scripture. This is found in Proverbs 16:2, and it says, you may think everything you do is right, but the Lord judges the motive. Does anybody want to pray for us? Let's bow our heads. Wonderful, merciful Father, we thank you so much that you have given us everything we need to live by in this book. We thank you for these two examples that we can learn from. May we all be motivated to be selfless, totally focused on you. We thank you for answering these prayers because we ask them in Jesus' name. Amen.
They sure have had a lot of fun putting it together.